People have had their products confiscated by the casino. The casino has taken their product that they purchased and said, you can't have this in here. What's going on, guys? Jacob Worth back here with another video of Jacob's Life in Vegas, coming to you guys with something that might be of importance to you. And actually, this is something you're probably gonna wanna share with your friends or anybody you know who is into cannabis products and, you know, plan to come to Vegas and, you know, buy cannabis products, and they plan on taking them on the strip with them. So here's something I came across on Twitter just recently, and this came from Vital Vegas. I saw the tweet on there. I will link to the tweet down below if you guys want to read his tweet and, you know, read the responses to all of this. But apparently this has been happening in Vegas probably ever since marijuana became legal here in the state of Nevada. But some of you may know that these casinos on the strip, they are not friendly to marijuana. They are not friendly to cannabis. They don't want anything to do with it because of the legality of it with state versus federal government. I'll talk about that a little later. But what has been happening, and what this tweet is about people who go into a casino property with their product that they buy, right, in a bag just like this. They're walking in, because you see people walk with these, you know, on the strip. You see them walk around town. They get out of one of the dispensaries, and, you know, they have their product in here. The casino sees it, and the casinos don't like that. And that's actually where I'm filming this video. Kind of ironic, I'm right in between the casinos and right in between a couple of dispensaries here that are truly just, you know, a short walk from the strip. So you can get your product, you can walk over, get your product here. But if you go into some of these casinos, they see this, the security is going to come up to you, and they're going to let you know you have to get rid of it, because casinos want nothing to do with it. And that's to the point too, where the tweet mentions that people have had their products confiscated by the casino. The casino has taken their product that they purchased and said, you can't have this in here. Now, the tweet didn't get into this, but I would imagine this is only for people who are staying at the hotel. The tweet specifically mentions actually the Wynn. So the Wynn and the Encore are ones who enforce this. I asked an employee in the dispensary here, also said, you know, the Venetian, the Palazzo. So really the two main properties that, you know, I've heard or I've been told are doing this. And I'm willing to bet there's other ones who do this too, because they're all subject to the same federal regulations. So if they see this and you're checking in or something like that, they're gonna tell you to get rid of it. Basically what it comes down to, it sounds like, is either you get rid of the product or you get rid of staying at the hotel. It's one of those two. So most people, even if they spend hundreds of dollars on product, they're just gonna get rid of it, take the loss, because they still wanna stay in their hotel room and they don't wanna hassle with that. That's what it's coming down to. Now, the reason this happens and the reason this is an issue is because of state versus federal law. And some people have talked on Twitter about the legality of this, saying, well, hey, it's my property, you can't take my property from me. You know, that's theft and that kind of thing. Well, I would imagine it can only be for hotel guests, because if you're not staying there at the hotel, it's your property. You did buy it. It is yours. So if you're not staying there and they see it, they could say, hey, you have to go, and you just walk out. But if you are staying there and they say, hey, we can't have this on property, because remember, these casinos are private property. So they can make rules and say, hey, we don't want this on our property. We don't want this on our property. It's their rules, okay? So if you're staying there, they could say, hey, look, you can either stay here or you can get rid of this stuff, or you can keep it, but you can't stay here with it because we don't want it here. So if you're not staying at the hotel, I don't see how they could actually take your stuff from you. So if you are staying at the hotel and they see this, then they're gonna tell you to get rid of it, or they're just gonna take it from you, one of the two. Because I've seen this before at a club where people would come, they would have product with them, and they would say, look, either you can keep it and leave, or you throw it away and you come in, you know, because they didn't want it in the building, because again, it was their property. So it's, again, state versus federal law, okay? Because Nevada legalized marijuana, right? We, you know, recently did it here in 2017. That's when Nevada legalized it. But even then, even when it was gonna become legal, these casinos have never been friendly towards it. Why? Because it's still federally illegal. So yeah, you can possess the product, and Nevada law is goofy right now, because you can come to these dispensaries, right? Dispensaries all over the area now. You can come, you can buy your product, but you legally cannot consume it unless you live here and it's in your personal residence, or someone who has property, you know, gives you permission to do it in their residence. So some people might, you know, choose to do an Airbnb or something where the owner of the property is, you know, friendly to that. They'll say, yeah, you can consume products, no problem. But these casinos, no, they're not having it. They're not doing it. They're not touching it. Until it becomes federally illegal, these casinos are staying way far away. Apparently, when it was, you know, on the way to becoming legal here in Nevada, regulators told the casinos, don't touch it, don't mess with it. Why? Because they don't want to lose their gaming license, okay? I mean, cannabis is a growing industry, and it's just gonna get bigger and bigger here in the U.S., but gaming, gambling, that revenue, the thing that these properties, right, the thing that, you know, really helped build this street into what it is today, they're not going to put that at risk. So I don't know if any of you have had this happen before, where maybe you've had some of your products taken from you. That's just how it is here on the Strip, you know, and how it is here in Nevada right now. Again, just because the laws are weird, you cannot just go smoke in your hotel room. It kind of goes without saying, as I've been talking in this video, if they don't want it on the property, they certainly don't want it in the hotel rooms either. They don't want people consuming in the hotel rooms. So that's why it was fairly big news when Nuwu opened their actual lounge that they had. I just did a video on that recently. When they opened their consumption lounge on tribal land, because now it gives people a place to legally consume what they purchase. So that's the only place in Nevada right now that you can actually go and consume. So now you have people that just, you know, they're kind of legally caught between a rock and a hard place. And, you know, hopefully the lounges become, you know, more accessible around the county, so you don't have issues like this anymore. And, you know, it can take any issues off of the casinos, off of the tourists who have their products, don't have to worry about getting taken. So I don't know if some of you had this happen to you before, but this is kind of like a PSA, like a public service announcement for those of you who are coming to Vegas or have friends that are coming and want to, you know, take advantage of buying some of these products. If the casinos see this bag, if they see anything that shows that you've been inside a dispensary, then they're probably going to come up to you with security and they're going to tell you, hey, either you got to get out or throw it out. Or if you're staying there, they might say throw it out or, you know, cancel your reservation. Just so you guys know. So guys, go ahead and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so yet, because there's always more content coming in the future about Las Vegas. I appreciate all of you guys watching this video. That's gonna be it for this one. I'm Jacob. This is my life in Vegas.